What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo from the BTNHD, and don't freak out, there is sound on this video. You just saw a super quick unboxing on Lenovo's ThinkStation P520, and this machine is a monster, and I loved it. Automatically, I fell in love with it, and let's get right into the review. All right, so what comes inside the box? Super self-explanatory. We have a statement on USB transfer rate. Awesome. We have a safety warranty setup guide. Cool. We have a heavy gauge power cable. Cool. We have a mouse, which I did not use at all. And we have one of those old school IBM keyboards. Ugh, I did not use this at all. But when we set up the machine, I'm going to use my own keyboard and mouse that I use on this machine when I was testing it out. All right. So this guy has a lot of ports on the front and the back. Let's go over some of the ports on the front side. Now, it comes with a DVD RW. RW stands for rewritable. I did not use this guy at all. Who uses a DVD or a CD, right? At the very top right here, we have a power button. Right next to the power button, you have your mic headphone combo jack. You have four 3.1 USB ports, and the last one right here is always on charging, which is awesome. And last but not least, we have our SD card reader slot. Now on the back side, let's turn this guy around real quick. At the top, we have a PS/2 port. This is old school ports for your keyboard and mouse. Right here, we have two 3.1 USB ports. Right next to that, we have our RJ45, which is a gigabit Ethernet port. We have two additional 3.1 USB ports, and last but not least, we have 2.0 USB ports. And last but not least, we have our microphone in ports, we have our audio out port, and then our audio in port. And underneath all these ports, we have our graphics card, which actually holds four display ports. And at the very bottom, we have our power port. This is where we are going to insert our power cable, which is right here. I'm gonna insert this guy right now to our power supply unit. All right, so we are going to take the machine, hook up a keyboard and mouse and a monitor. We're gonna boot it up. We're gonna take a look at some of the specifications and go over some of the pros and cons on this machine. So let's get right into that right now. All right, so before I even turn this guy on, this is a heavy machine. It weighs around 27.55 pounds. So make sure wherever you set it, I recommend setting it on top of a desktop. Don't put it on the floor, you know, because you don't want to cover up the rear vents. You want to keep it nice and cool. All right, so the power button is located right here at the top. We are going to press this guy on, and we're going to turn it on. You hear that power? Awesome. Now, one of the cool things on the ThinkStation P520 is that it has a front panel input and output controller, which is like located right in here next to the panel of the front. It is extremely hard to even get into, but there is a speaker inside of that panel. Now the speaker loudness on the P520, I got around 85.2 decibels. That is not that bad. Most of the time I was able to use the speaker with no problems. If you don't want to use the internal speaker, you can always plug in external monitors at the back using the audio input and output that the P520 gives you. All right, so we just went over the speakers on the 520, the P520. Again, speakers are like really hidden. They're really small, right? But what makes this machine a monster is the specifications. You are able to customize it on your own, like solid state drives, M.2 solid state drive, more memory. You could do that all on your own. Again, we're going to open it up pretty soon, and I'm going to show you guys inside of it because it's super simple. You could upgrade it yourself. So on the desktop, we are going to right click on the taskbar. We are going to go inside Task Manager. I'm gonna open this guy up real quick. I actually have Camtasia Recorder 9 running, recording the screen for you guys. We are going to go to performance and let's go to CPU. Let's right click on the CPU, go to change graph to logical processors. And this guy is running an Intel Xeon W2145 CPU with a clock speed of 3.70 gigahertz. It has 8 cores, 16 logical processors. It has virtualization enabled, which I loved a lot because I actually had VMware Workstation 15 installed and I was just playing around with my virtual environment. Love it. Now, for memory, it comes with 16 gigs. You are able to upgrade up to 512 gigs of memory. Now, for hard drive space, I only got the 512 gigabyte solid state drive. It is actually an M.2 solid state drive, which is awesome. You have your gigabit RJ45 ports. These two guys are right here is because I installed VMware Workstation. Those are my virtual NICs. And last but not least, you have the NVIDIA Quadro P4000 8 gigs graphics card, which is a monster. Now, the refresh rate as well as the resolution on this particular graphics card, it really depends on what you are inserting into this machine. Like right now, I have a 1080p machine, so I don't really have a high refresh rate. But if we open up, let's open up Tech Power Up GPU. Let's hit yes on the user account control. Let's launch this guy up real quick. And if we do a lookup on the NVIDIA Quadro P4000, it's going to open up right here. So, okay. So the max resolution would be around 3840 by 2160. And it really depends on the monitor, okay? Recommend the gaming resolutions. It only goes up to 1920 1080. It start going up to yellow and red when you are using a 2K or 4K monitor. So be careful on that. Now, the only problem that I noticed on the fonts, it just looks kind of weird. Now, the particular cable that I have is a display to HDMI. So I think if you had a display to display, the fonts won't look all kind of weird to me. I mean, to me, it looks all like really fine and weird. I don't know if it's because of my eyes or it looks weird. But right now, I'm currently using a display port to the computer and display to HDMI. I feel like if I had a native display to display, the fonts won't look all weird to me. But hey, that's me. Now for heating, again, it's a desktop. It does have two fans, one fan in the front and one fan at the back, which keeps it nice and cool. But I did notice heating around the normal areas on a desktop. Again, I do recommend having it on top of a desktop. Don't put this guy on the floor, stuck in the corner, catching all that dust, because you will lose performance. Performance-wise, I enjoyed it a lot. I was able to do DaVinci, a lot of color editing, Premiere, rendering 4K with Media Encoder, Photoshop, gaming. I was able to do everything on this machine with no problem. It's a desktop workstation. This guy is built for engineers, designers, and animators. All right, so let's conclude our review on the ThinkStation P520. Pricing. Let's talk about the pricing. Now, the retail price for this guy is around $1,350. And the highest that you could go with all the configurations, with everything, memory, you know, upgrade the solid state drive, get a better graphics card, it's going to be around 10 grand. Ugh, it's not really an affordable machine. I think this machine is built for the work environment, especially if you are a senior engineer or an animator or a designer that needs that type of power, that power of the graphics, the memory, the solid state drive, the processor. Go for it. You know, if you're using you know, Revit, if you're using 3D Max, if you're using Maya, those are the type of programs that you are able to use on this particular machine. Don't get me wrong, when I was rendering 4K video using the P4000, it was quick, dude. I mean, really, really fast. Now, for external monitors, again, you got the graphics card that holds around 4 display ports. I was actually using a display port to an HDMI cable, and I saw like the fonts weren't too great. So if you're a designer, you're definitely going to complain about the font type on the monitor. So I would definitely recommend doing a display to display. Get a monitor that's able to hook up a display cable and go for that route. Like I mentioned before, this guy is customizable. Like if I turn it right here to the side, this is the latch that allows you to open up the side panel. You're allowed to only open this side right here. The other side, you can't open it at all. There is a key right here in the bottom that allows you to lock it. It's like a server. So opening it up is super simple. So you could just press this guy right here, lift it up, and voila, it's opened up. Now the power supply is a really good power supply to support everything that this machine has inside of it. The power supply is around 690 watts. Again, this machine is super easy to upgrade. You are able to go up to 2 terabytes of SATA state drive and up to 6 terabytes, 72 RPMs, which is awesome. Like this right here is the housing that allows you to hook up your SATA as well as your solid state drives. So this right here would be your SATA. And for your solid state drives, this would be the mechanism. This little guy right here. There we go. So this guy right here is actually the mechanism that allows you to hook up the 2.5 solid state drives into it. So let me put that back. Now for memory, it actually has 8 DIMMs in total, 4 in each side of the CPU. You could go up to 512 gigabytes with a clock speed of 2933. Now, overall, this machine is a monster. I'm going to say it again. It is a great machine for those people that are designers, that are animators, and engineers. If you're looking for a machine to use for maybe live stream, for decoding, encoding, I would definitely use that. Upgrade the RJ45 to maybe a dual port so you can have like incoming and outgoing kind of traffic. It's really up to you. It's not affordable. It's really expensive. And that's it, guys. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this video. Make sure to hit that thumbs up. Do not forget about smashing that subscribe button. Also, hit that notification bell to get the latest and greatest from this guy. And I catch you guys on the next review. Peace out.